A TSBVI outreach tutorial. The Orion TI-36X Talking Scientific Calculator, Part 4, Fractions. Presented by Susan Osterhaus, a Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Math Consultant.
All right, and I'm going to just look at my little cheat sheet of which problem I wanted to do next, and the next one is on fractions. Here we've got this Talking Scientific Calculator, and so far all I've done are some very basic things. I'm showing you these, first of all, to let you know you can still do basic things on it as well. And the reason I'm going to show you fractions is that that is the most exciting part of this calculator for the majority of your students. The first time they're going to use it, they're probably going to be in ninth grade taking Algebra 1, or maybe even earlier than that if they take Algebra 1 in eighth grade. And they're going to be so excited because of what I'm going to show you that it will do with fractions. So let's say that we're going to enter the fraction 4/3. We're going to go ahead and press 4. And then we're going to find what we call the fraction key, which again, it's first column, and instead of all the way down to the bottom or the first row, it's going to be the one just above that, and you're going to hear this.
A and B over C.
That's what you want to hear, and then you're going to press 3.
3.
And in case you're not sure, because I've been talking quite a bit as to what you've really entered onto the calculator, remember we have that repeat key on the side, so I'm going to press that.
Repeat. 4/3.
Okay, so with all that talking, I still have it correct. It's 4/3, and then I'm going to multiply, so I know where my multiply is.
Multiply.
And I'm going to have another fraction, 7/8. 7/8. So I'm going to go ahead and do 7.
7. A and B over C, 8.
And now I've just entered 7/8. If you're not sure, do that repeat button.
Repeat. 7/8.
Okay, I did that correctly. You do not have to do that, what I just did. I'm just, just making sure, reassuring myself that I entered it correctly. And then equals?
Equals 1 and 1/6.
So what it just gave us was an answer in the form of a mixed number. Let me repeat that for you.
Repeat 1 and 1/6.
So it gave you an answer of 1 1/6. But what happens sometimes in math classes, the math teacher says, I like that answer, it's correct, but I want you to change it to an improper fraction, okay? So in that case, you're going to come up here, and I'm going to select, in the first column, I'm going to select the second button, which just also happens to say second on it, and it happens to be blue, but I'm going to press that.
Second.
Because what that's going to do is do the second function for my fraction button. So let's see what that second function is.
Convert fraction 7/6.
Okay, so what the second function for the fraction button is it converts it to an improper fraction. Let's listen again.
Repeat, 7/6.
Okay, so it's changed the 1 1/6 to 7/6. And we now have an improper fraction. Now, if your poor student has a teacher like me, I'm going to say something like, well, you know what? I like that improper fraction, but I just looked at the answers choices on the tax test, and all they have are decimal answers. So now what are we going to do? Do you need to start all over and do that problem completely over again, but using decimals from the get-go? No. This time, we're going to go back to the first column and take the very, very first button, first column, first row, upper left-hand corner, and press, and you're going to hear?
Third.
Now, this is a green button, and it says third. We have a third function, believe it or not, on that fraction key. And look what that is. I'm going to go all the way back down, get my fraction key.
Fraction, exchange, decimal, 1.16666666667.
Now it has converted our fraction. First it converted the mixed number to an improper fraction, and now it has converted it to decimal form. And most of the students at this time would be going, ooh, wow, 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 wow. And I think most teachers will be very happy with this as well. And again, if you have a teacher who still wants you to continue to change, remember you can go take that third function button again.
Third.
It's a toggle.
Fraction, exchange, decimal, 1 and 1/6.
So that's a toggle. It changes now. It changed it back from a decimal to a mixed number. And then again, if you want to change it back to an improper fraction, The second.
Second.
And the fraction key again.
Convert fraction 7 over 6.
So very, very nice key to have along with its second and third function. And if you think this is difficult, and I'm thinking in terms of adults, it's much more difficult for adults than it is for students. And students, when they realize how much work that is doing for them, they absolutely love having that. They would want the calculator if that's all it could do, because fractions for many of them are so difficult and time consuming. So just to let you know that, that's a very important key.
This video continues in the TSBVI Outreach Tutorial Series, Orion Calculator. Look for other videos by Susan Osterhaus on Math for the Blind and Visually Impaired. A TSBVI Outreach Distance Learning Production. Executive Producers, William Daugherty, Superintendent. Cyril Miller, Outreach Director. Outreach Producers, Susan Osterhaus, Math Consultant. Mike Bicknell, Media Specialist. Texas School for the Blind and Visually Impaired Outreach Programs. 1100 West 45th Street, Austin, Texas 78756, USA. Telephone 512-454-8631. Website www.tsbvi.edu. Video copyright TSBVI 2010. All rights reserved.